There we are, just filling the washing and rinsing buckets for the cider for 2010. There's most of the press, there's the base, the top, a couple of chunks of wood. That's the support base. Kind of welded those extra bits on because they messed up the design. Obviously there's supports where the holes are, both sides. You know, that's not going to flex that much, that's a lot stronger than the oak. There's the top bit. And we've kind of welded a cup in there. The top of the jack goes in there, so there's no chance of it slipping away. And there are the uprights, M25 stainless steel. And that's just a bit of the scratter. And underneath there is 8 containers, each got about 35 kilos in, so we've got about 300, give or take, 300 kilos of apples to do today, and it's the middle of September, we're a bit early.
Those have already gone rotten. You can see the base there on its wheels. These.
Dropping. A few more. Side. There you go. So bottom and sides. Well, this is a scratter. There's a machine, a barrel with the screws in. It's actually split this year. There's a bit of a crack there. It's made out of 4 pieces. And there's a bit of a crack there and a crack there, so it's not actually going to last forever. Now this bit, the metal cutting plate. See if I can do it one-handed. Drops on there like that. This bit sits on there. It's just a support for the hopper. So there you go. Hopper together. You're on YouTube. Lou's just sterilising all the barrels we've got. There's 60 litres and there's a smaller 30 litre one there. She's using BWP solution. All those are washed now, 5. Those are washing. The top one just needs doing. So we're getting there. Presses together-ish. Still need a few more bits. The scratter's ready. This is the new. As you can see, Lewis is just kind of throwing it in there, feed it forward, beats it. It eats and eats and eats. Look at that. Just pommies galore.
Hang on, oh, we got a bit of jam. Got a bit of a jam for a change. We'll just give that a bit of a ram. Get going again. There we go. This is Lou, fourth cheese. The Scratter, perfect for this year. We've done half of it in, how long did it take, 15 minutes?
15, yeah, 15, 20.
So that's about 150 kilos of apples in 15 minutes, and the pomace is great. There's liquid pouring out of it, as you can see. You know, it's going to be great, and the recovery from this, we'll get up to 60-70% of the liquid from this back. So we are just, we're not using gloves this time. We're fully organic. No, we've had our hands in VDP all morning, so I'm pretty sure, I mean, look at the juice. Just look at that, just wanting to come out. We've already got half a bucket full down there. No, that's about it, Lou, I think, on that one. Just flatten it down, and we've been pressing for about 20 minutes. We've just got to the first full extension of the jack. There's loads more in. We've got, 30 litres? One go, and there's loads left in there. You know, that's going to go down. We're going to try and compress it down to about here. So there's loads more in there to come out. So hopefully one of these should fill one of those. That's the
even
plan.
Though we've welded a 20 millimeter lip on there, we're still nearly flooded the it's just pouring out. Nearly flooded the bottom tray.
We're about to do the second press now. What we do, I don't know if you can see this, we've actually wound down the crosshead because it's on threaded bars. You don't need to chock the base, you just wind the screws down. So it's actually turned out to be a really effective.
Well, you can see how flat we're getting everything now. Those pancakes were 3 inches high. We've got another couple of gallons in the bucket. I mean, there's so much force being put on this now. That is a 10 millimeter 316 stainless steel plate, and you can see it's bent. We can only just press the jack down, so we assume we're close to the 30 tons. We're up to 25 tons at least on that, so there's so much pressure. The wood's crushing.
Well, on the last press, we've only done three to do 300 kilos, so that's not bad. So basically, it's a 100 litre press, so 100 kilos of pomace can go in it, and we've been filling one of these out of it. Well, there's one there, and there's all this to go. So we've done a lot better than last year. The press we have broken as well. We've managed to bend the top bit, so we've exceeded the yield strength of the I section. The original plan was actually to get one that was 6 inches high and 6 inches wide, and obviously, as you can see, that's not. So we might have to make... might have to get some bigger eye section for next year. I mean, you can see the bend in it there. It's that's quite good actually to show the see the curve, and it's obviously it's yielded in an uneven way. It hasn't bent upwards, it's kind of bent out sideways. Yeah, Lou just filling it up for the last time. I'm pooped. I've got no strength left, my back's aching. I've been cleaning apples since 8 o'clock this morning, so I'm just taking a breather for 5 minutes. Doing a bit of videoing, we'll watch Lewis slave away and get everything in there. The pomace this year has been, it's a lot juicier. You've got to really grind it down finely, and the finer you get it, you want it like apple sauce. So to be honest, even a bit further than what we've got here, but it'll do for us for this home project. And the Scratter, to be honest, is fantastic. We could have done 3 or 4 tons of pomace with the Scratter. We've actually kind of used it for 5 or 10 minutes and then stopped, and then sort of messed around with the press for the rest of the time. So the Scratter is very, very
tired. He's just finished putting the last one together. So we've done three today. It's actually 3:45, so we've only been scratting and pressing for 3.5 hours. And I think last year we were doing it till 10, 11 o'clock at night. So I don't know whether we're more organised or more experienced, or it's just been, the Scratter's been easier to use. The press has been, obviously we've been able to put in more in the press each time, so the press has been more effective. So yeah, all in all, it has been a fantastic day. 300 kilos of apples. It's taken from about 9 o'clock this morning to about now, which is 4:45, and we'll probably finish about 12:30. Go girl. You can't hear any juice running yet.
No, not yet.
Both very tired. It's been hard work. We both got backache. But it's been worth it. We've done really good.
Full load. Using a drill pump.
Excellent, but this is literally, you can see the bend in it. I'd love to know how much force is going into that. The equipment to do that, the measuring equipment to do that is really expensive, so we'd never get to find out. Do you want to give it a bit more? Bit more juice. He's really having to put his weight on it now. You can imagine the force. We've been crushing the piece of wood underneath the pan, and just have a look at the pan. The pan's seen better days. Are we crushing the wood yet? Well, I can hear it creaking. That's probably about it, actually. Yeah. That's.
That's definitely.
Can you see the bend? Look at that. So, I mean, the amount of force needed to bend this ice section is colossal, and we've used it. It's but luckily, it's metal, so it doesn't fail catastrophically. It'll yield and bend, so we're quite safe. It'll just bend out of the way. It's not going to snap on us and go catapulting above the roof like it did last year. It's a shame we weren't recording then, actually. It would have been, as I say, we would have been a fantastic viral video. But that's it. As you can see, flat cheeses. Very flat. They're about, well, in some places a bit wider there and a bit narrower there. I think because this is the last press, we'll just leave it for a while and let it settle, and then, in fact, I'll put a couple more cranks on it now. There's the thing, there we are. Let's give it a couple of cranks. Oh, that is really, really stiff. You can only just do it with one arm. That's funny.
You can see the bending moment in it. Scared now. I mean, the crush force on that is just immense. That's bent more than 10 millimetres. That's, would you eat?
Good man.
We've broken it anyway. It's going to need replacing. Oh, now that is really...
That's beyond design.
So, bigger ice section next time. The 6-inch by 6-inch is a must with 30 tonnes. I can't get on that. I'll let it off, that's